Good morning, class. This is Mr. Devlok Anand, Bhavara Devra Saraswati Vidya Mandir, TCT English. So today we shall read about a poem, A Tiger in the Zoo by Leslie Norris. Before going to read the poem, I want to give you a brief discussion about Leslie Norris, the poet of the poem. Leslie Norris, as you know, was born in Britain in the year 1921. He composed many poems, including many short stories. A Tiger in the Zoo is one of them. So now, we'll start the lesson, A Tiger in the Zoo by Leslie Norris. He stalks in his vivid stripes, the few steps of his cage, on pads of velvet quiet, in his quiet rage. The following stanza depicts of the tiger in the zoo. He is caught in the cage. He stalks in his vivid stripes. That it means that he is wearing stripes that is of different color, yellow and black. The few steps of his cage. He is moving inside his cage on pads of velvet quiet. Here, velvet quiet and quiet rage. Words are alliterations and they are repeated constantly. Velvet, see, velvet and quiet. And just like that, quiet and rage. So the tiger is moving on its velvet feet and his quiet rage means he is very angry. He is not happy at all. Now the para number second. He should be lurking in shadow, sliding through the long grass near the water hole where plump deer pass. The poet Leslie Norris now indicates that the tiger should be in the jungle. His actual place is in the jungle and where he is sliding through the long grasses. And moreover, the tiger must be in search of the deer and who are very fat enough for his dinner and that he should be lurking in shadow instead of living in the cage. Now the stanza number three. In the stanza number three, he should be snarling around houses at the jungle's edge. The poet Leslie Norris states that there is no place of tiger in the zoo and now he should be snarling around the houses in the jungles at the jungle's edge bearing his white fangs. Here, white fangs means his white and yellow teeth and his claws which are very sharp and that can tear almost all animals' flesh. And there he is doing terrorizing the village. The poet tells us that the tiger, when it snarls around the houses at the jungle, says, terrorizes the village and the people. He is wearing his white fangs and his claws, but is locked in a concrete cell. It is very much unfortunate for the tiger that he is not open in the open. He is locked inside the concrete cell. His strength behind bars. His total strength is behind the bars as he cannot come out of that, stalking the length of his cage, ignoring visitors. So when the visitors are coming to see him, so he's just ignoring them. He has nothing to take and give. He is just thinking and thinking to be free. Just he is stalking the length of his cage, measuring the length of his cage. If he gets any chance to move out of there, he will go for sure. And so he is ignoring the visitors. Now, the final stanza of the poem, he hears the last voice at night. That it means that at the night, he is still awake. He is not asleep. He is watching and observing the sound of the patrolling cars that passes through behind on the road and stares with his brilliant eyes at the brilliant stars. He has no work to do. He is nothing doing. He is just staring on the stars in the sky and gazing those brilliant stars. The rhyming scheme of the poem is A, B, C, D. Here, night represents the rhyming scheme as A, night, cars is the B, eyes is the C, and stars again is the B. A, B, C, B. So, the rhyming scheme is like A, B, C, B. The summary of the poem finally. This poem contrasts a tiger in the zoo with the tiger in its natural habitat. The poet has written it beautifully that how a tiger in the zoo is under freedom and he wants to be free like he is to be in the natural habitat. The boy moved from the zoo to the jungle and again back again to the zoo. So the thought of the poem about the tiger in the zoo is very much affectionate, and he wants the tiger not in the zoo but in the forest, in the free environment. Now, George Leslie Norris, earlier I have seen you that he was born on 21st May 1921 and was died on 6 April 2006. Was a prize winning Welsh poet. He was born in Wales, that is a state in the Britain, and he was also a short story writer. He taught at academic institutions in Britain and in the United States. He was a man of great knowledge and scholar, including Brigham Young University. Norris is considered one of the most important Welsh writers of the post-war period, and his literary publications have won many prizes. Not only this, whatever you say about the poet is not, it will be very less. He is such a great writer and a composer and a poet and a shortest writer that cannot be compared with most other renowned poets of the world. Leslie Norris, in his poem A Tiger in the Zoo, has showed his consideration towards the tiger which is caught in the cage. Moreover, he says that he should not be there. He should be kept free, and he should be snarling in the jungle and just riding the village, which is his habit. Thank you very much.